Many of you know the spirit of Jezebel. How many of you know the spirit of Lilith? Lilith is a female demon of the night and a succubus who flies out searching for newborn children to kidnap or strangle and sleeping with men in their dreams in order to produce demon children. The spirit of Lilith is very sneaky and can often be confused with Jezebel as she shares some of the characteristics of the Jezebel spirit. She likes to target men just like Jezebel, especially men anointing to preach the word of God, or those who have an anointing to come against the kingdom of darkness. Her symbols are the crossroad, an owl, a serpent, a tree, and dark moon. There are many ways she can enter you. Lilith spirits can come in through receiving an abortion, through generational curses, soul ties, or other sexual sins. The spirit of Lilith is very ruthless and will not leave you without deliverance or the hand of God on you. When Isaiah prophesies God's wrath against nations of Edom in Isaiah 34 verse 14, he said, "Among the howling and hissing wild creatures and demons, Lilith herself, demoness of the night, will call Edom her haunt, a place to recoup and rest between her devastating forays." Lilith's symbol has allowed different groups to use her as a symbol of female power. Many feminists see Lilith as not only the first woman, but the first independent woman created. What the feminist movement do not understand, life is spiritual. And by using this demonic entity, their objectives will never be achieved. The devil is a liar. Nothing he say will be the truth. Lilith is a spirit that will cause men and women to give up on their destiny. It is a spirit that loves to bring frustration and anxiety. She loves sex. The nastier, the better. The spirit of Lilith loves to convince people to have multiple partners. She loves to attract people in their sleep with intense dreams of having sex with children or animals. The spirit of Lilith loves to watch children suffer and loves abortion because killing children with lots of blood is how she sexually gets aroused. It is a spirit that loves to kill and destroy. She loves heartache and suffering. She will cause spouses in marriage to have an affair. Her goal is always to destroy as many people as possible. Sexual perversion is her thing. One of the ways that the spirit of Lilith attacks is that she visits people at night when they are sleeping. She plants sexual thoughts and causes them to have wet dreams. She then takes the sperm and uses it in the spirit in a number of ways. First, to impregnate female cult members and breed babies for sacrifice. Taking to motherships and to use for test tube fertilization to create Nephilims. To create half-human, half-animal creatures. Also, used in a spiritual sperm bank to be used by Satan in whatever way he chooses. My advice to anyone listening to me today is to stay away from anything that has to do with this evil spirit. There are many artists in the music and movie industry who uses her symbol. And many of you wear her symbol without having any understanding and unknowingly open the door for her to enter you and curse you and your family for 3 to 4 generations. There's an artist who has an owl symbol for his clothing line. He knows why he has the symbol, but none of you do. There are sacrifices made by these people in order to gain wealth and status. My friend, again, life is spiritual. The Bible says in Hosea 4 verse 6, "My people are destroyed for lack of knowledge. Because you have rejected knowledge, I also reject you from being priests for me. Because you have forgotten the law of your God, I also will forget your children." If you in the past had opened a door for this spirit to come in, tonight is the night you close it. Renounce all the shapes and names of Lilith. Please understand again, life is spiritual. Ephesians 6 verse 10 to 12 tells us, "Finally, my brethren, be strong in the Lord and in the power of his might. Put on the whole armor of God that you may be able to stand against the wiles of the devil. For we do not wrestle against flesh and blood, but against principalities, against powers, against the rulers of the darkness of this age, against spiritual hosts of wickedness in the heavenly places. Therefore, take up the whole armor of God, that you may be able to withstand in the evil day, and having done all, to stand." Let us pray. Now we declare, O Lord, that you and you alone are our God, and besides you, there is no other. A just God, a Savior, the Father, the Son, and the Spirit, and we worship you. We submit ourselves afresh to you this day in unreserved obedience. Having submitted to you, Lord, we do as your word directs. We resist the devil, all his pressures, his attacks, and his deceptions, every instrument or agent he will seek to use against us. We do not submit. We resist him, drive him from us, and exclude him from us in the name of Jesus. We thank you that through the sacrifice of Jesus on the cross, we have passed out from under the curse and enter into the blessings of Abraham, whom you bless in all things, exaltation, health, reproduction, prosperity, victory, and God's favor. Heavenly Father, I want to thank you for the blood of Jesus that reconciles us back unto you. I want to thank you for the blood of Jesus that cleanses us from all sins in the name of Jesus, the Messiah. I declare that I am born out of God, and that no evil spirit has any hold over me. I belong to you, Abba Father, spirit, soul, and body. I submit myself to you, Abba Father, and I resist the devil in the powerful name of Jesus the Messiah, and therefore he must flee. Father, forgive me for allowing Lilith into my life and for becoming a victim of her seduction. Forgive me for allowing lust to control me, for allowing unholy soul tie to be formed. Forgive me, Abba Father, for defiling my marriage bed with lust and for desecrating your holy union between husband and wife. I renounce lust as a sin in Jesus' mighty name. Father, I now declare a divorce between myself and Lilith and all her children. I tear up the marriage certificate and I give back her wedding ring. I ask that your holy fire in the name of Jesus the Messiah destroy all the documents that testify against me in the spirit. I break any and all relationships between every evil spirit of lust and seduction and myself. I destroy every unholy soul tie between myself and Lilith and all her other names with the sword of the Spirit. In the name of Jesus the Messiah, I declare that Satan has no longer any access to my body, my soul, or my spirit through that soul tie. In the name of Jesus the Messiah, I declare that Lilith and her children have no access to my children anymore. All access to my children through this spirit and soul tie is now cut off by the power of God. I now cover my children with the blood of the Lamb, and that the doors of her access to them will be sealed forever with your blood. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ, I fire every gatekeeper who helped Lilith to get access to me. I strip them of all power and authority, and I tear off their appointment letters in the name of Jesus the Messiah. And I ask that you burn these documents in the fire of the Holy Spirit. I seal every gate with the blood of Jesus, and I ask that you appoint your warring angels to guard these gates. I ask that you close every gate in the mirror in my home that have access to the caves of Lilith and seal it with the blood of Jesus. I renounce any connection with the moon, its rays, and its four stages, especially the new moon. In the almighty name of Jesus the Messiah, I cut myself loose from these connections with the moon and its connection with Lilith. I renounce my connection with Egypt, and I cut myself loose from anything to do with Egypt in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. I renounce any worship giving to the dark inner side, feminine side, and the power of the ultimate divine feminine to dissolve all forms in the name of Jesus the Messiah. I renounce their unmanifest aspect that result in nothingness in the name of Jesus the Messiah. I renounce the static state of love and the sexual power that I gained through Lilith in the name of Jesus Christ. In the powerful name of Jesus, I cut myself loose from the waters in heaven, on the earth, and under the earth, as well as from Leviathan and all the powers connected to it. Father, I ask you to destroy the web of Lilith that she used to entangle me and to free me completely from her web of lust and intoxication. I ask you, Father, to strip Lilith of her armor and to paralyze her as a warrior in the name of Jesus. I renounce all shapes and names of Lilith, and I ask you, Abba Father, to cut me loose from each one of her names and shapes and to destroy every unholy soul tie in this regard in the name of Jesus. I renounce her blood-sucking kisses and her vampirism and the total fatigue I experience as a result. Father, I ask that you heal the wounds where she sucked up my blood and that you will restore my strength, which she has drawn out of me. I ask you, Abba Father, to seal off the holes made by her teeth, body, soul, and spirit. Father, I bring before you every time the spirit Lilith took any sperm or ovum in my family line and used it for certain purposes. I ask you to destroy every place where any sperm in my family line is stored with your fire. I ask forgiveness where my family's seeds or my own seed was used to create babies to be sacrificed on the altars of Satan. I ask you to destroy any seed of my family and me that was harvested by Lilith to be placed into sperm banks to be used for certain purposes. I ask you, Father, to please destroy the test tube and corrupt the seed that has been stolen so that it can never again be used by Satan in any way. Please destroy every demonic altars where these evil acts that were performed with our seeds. With the hammer of your word, we now smash these altars together with all the time clocks that were set up in the spirit to kick in at certain times and season over my family and me, past, present, and future. Send your fire, Father, and destroy all traces of evidence against my family. May the blood of Jesus have the final word over our lives. Father, I ask that you turn around the total destruction that follows Lilith and turn it into growth and blessings. Abba, Father, I ask you to sanctify and cleanse my marriage bed with the blood of Jesus the Messiah. Will you heal my marriage and restore my spirit and soul tied with my spouse, making our marriage an image of Jesus' relationship with his bride, the church? I ask you in the name of my Lord Jesus Christ to cover our seed with the blood of Jesus the Messiah, to prevent Lilith from stealing it and using it for her evil ends. Father, I now declare that I will wear the helmet of salvation to protect my mind, my conscious, and my subconscious mind in my dream world. I declare that I cast down all arguments and every high thing that exalts itself against the knowledge of God, bringing every thought into captivity to the obedience of the Messiah, Jesus. I thank you, Father, for your mercy and for your grace, and I give you all the honor, all the glory, and all the adoration, because you alone are God, and I belong to you. In Jesus' mighty name, amen.